With an extensive experience of over 30 years in Indian automobile market, Mr. Arun Malhotra has worked with many well-known auto brands in various markets across India. He will be sharing with you what has been his hits and misses. May we please invite on stage Mr. Arun Malhotra, auto industry veteran and MD Nissan India. Let's have a big round of applause, guys.
Good morning. Good morning. So, you know, when I was looking at this topic which Nabeel has given me, I was talking to a few people when I was coming inside, so they said, is it something like, sach ka samana, are you going to make two confessions today? Or are you going to do something like, aapki adalat, aap pe aarop hai, Rajya Sharma? So I said, nothing like that. I'll just be sharing with you my perspectives, my insights, and my experiences. And there are a lot of, I've learned from most of you here, a lot of eminent personalities are here. We have Mr. Nikunj Sanghi. Where is Nikunj? He is there, I saw him a few moments back. Veterans of industry like Gyaneshwar Sen is there, Mr. Kalsi was there, Mr. Rakesh Batra is there, Mr. Abdul Majid is there, dealer friends are here, a lot of dealer friends. If I name a few, it will not be appropriate. I'd like to just go back. The way I look at the industry, I came into the industry in 1983. I joined my job just 3 days before India won the World Cup under Kapil Dev. So that's what I remember it round. You know, the first, I'll go through phases, what's happened in the industry, what has my experiences, what has changed, and what has not changed at all. Because a lot of things have remained constant. So just to get to this phase, 1983 to 86 was a very, very critical phase in the auto industry. I don't know how many of you know, 9 Japanese companies came to India between 83 to 86. 9 Japanese companies. Which 9 Japanese auto companies? I'm not talking of Sony, I'm not talking of Panasonic. So you had the 4 Japanese companies in motorcycles coming in, the Yamaha, the Honda, the Suzuki, and the Kawasaki with their collaborators in India. Then you had the 4 light commercial vehicles companies coming in, which tied up with the Indian companies. There was Toyota with DCM, Isuzu Mitsubishi, Elvin Nissan, and also Swaraj Mazda. And last but not the least, there was Maruti Suzuki also, which came in. So this was a phase in 2 years which a lot of companies came in. And there were very dramatic differences which happened. The 4 Japanese companies, motorcycles who came in, made a complete transformation of the industry. The Yamaha, the Honda, the Suzuki, the Kawasaki, they came in a time, I think Suzuki started first in 84, followed by Hero Honda, and then came Kawasaki. Also was there, and Yamaha was definitely there. And these made a difference in the two-wheel industry. The two-wheel industry, which was dominated by 3 companies, or there were 3 big companies. One was Enfield, one was Escorts, and one was ESD. And they all had to pass through rough phase. But on the other hand, the 4 companies which came in the light commercial vehicles, and they came with a very strong pedigree, they could not make an impact. And they did struggle for a few years. What was the reason for this? And then the Maruti Suzuki came in 83, December, which changed the face of the Indian car industry because that was also a Fiat ambassador at that point of time. So if I look at the industry at that time, you know, what was the size of the two-wheeler or size of the car market that time? Can anybody make a guess? How many cars were sold or cars plus UVs, passenger vehicles were sold in 83, 84? Any guesses? It was 60,000 in the entire year, 5,000 a month. And how many two-wheelers were sold? That was slightly bigger pie, 6 lakhs. Effectively, the industry, two-wheeler industry, the four-wheel industry has gone up by 50 times from 83, 84 to 2017. And the two-wheel industry has gone up by 35, 40 times. Huge. It's unbelievable. But that is true. One of the experiences which one learned, I was talking about motorcycles because that was the field where I was there initially. When the 4 Japanese vehicles came, there was one brand. I don't know how many remember the brand called ESD. Arey, sab yaad karte hain. Nikunj ji, aap to 57 vintage ke, aapko yaad hoga. To aapke time to tha. If there was a more powerful brand in the country today, I can't think of a brand being more powerful, more image, more weighting. This was a brand which was like, if you had a SD motorcycle in Delhi University, I don't want to say follow later, everything followed. And it was an iconic brand. Then we had Rajdoot, which was more rural, and Enfield also had a very rural state. You'll be surprised, from a superhero status or a superstar status in 84, the Ideal Java Private Limited company, which manufactured ESD, became a big zero in 86. So this was a big transformation in 2 years. How could a company which was a superstar, absolute superstar, can become a super zero? It's unbelievable, but it's true. And why did it happen? Because I was close to industry. Because I hope nobody is representing Ideal Java management here, because sometimes it's difficult to speak, you know, somebody is there. Huh? That management anyway would have been needed for. No focus on customers, no parts available. Parts were sold, auctioned in Mysore. Dealers used to come and they used to auction, they used to take part in auction of spare parts. Waiting customers' advances taken for 8 months. Service, nothing, but it had that power, it had that agility. But when customers got a better alternative in terms of power, pickup, acceleration, when the Yamaha, Honda, Suzuki, and the Kawasaki's came, it just collapsed. So one learning which clearly comes out, if you don't look after your customers, even in times when it was not competitive times, I'm not talking 2017, you can disappear overnight. Then you had a second brand, Rajdoot did continue for some years, but it had declining curve. Enfield was a very unique story. The brand was under tremendous pressure, because it was rural. Kai log to kehte the, I hope, how many Enfield dealers are here? Any dealers who handled Enfield? No dealers? Okay. Okay, okay, so Enfield. So I have to be careful when I talk, you know. Although I speak positive things about Enfield. This brand really struggled. And for 8-10 years, it was just on the fringe, from a volume of 2,500, 1,000. Look at how the brand has come back in the last 10 years. Today, it's the fastest growing brand. It's growing, clocking growth rates of 25%. The share price of Eicher Motors, of which 80% is contributed by Enfield Motorcycle in terms of turnover, probably profits in 140% terms, is something like 31,000. So if you had invested in Eicher Motors share looking at Enfield 5 years back, your return would have been 6 times. So obviously, but they focused on the core thing, because the pleasure of driving a motorcycle, the pleasure of this thing. So here was one company which lost its moorings, which had its challenges, but under the new management came back, and today it is a superstar. And there's another company I talked of, ESD, 84, disappeared. So this was one learning clearly coming out. Those were the days of also, you know, bookings. License, permit, quota, Raj. Who founded that statement? Chakravarti Rajagopalacharya. Bajaj scooters, 110 crores booking, 23 lakh customers waiting for Bajaj scooters. Can you believe it? But true. Maruti, when they came in 85, 87, they also had a lot of booking, although their booking was limited. I still remember, I had to make one or two confessions I must make. When I joined Bajaj Auto in 90, after 7-8 years of tough experience, all products were on waiting, so I said, good, at least time to relax in life. Kabhi na to aram karna hai. But I didn't know they had recruited, because they had doubled their production and the demand was going down. And the first day it hit us, all the booking disappeared. So when I look at booking figures these days, I always look, 22 lakh bookings disappeared in 4 months. I can still tell you, I was in a dealership in Lucknow Commercial Motors. I was a regional manager. I was going through their booking records. Big, big, you know, pothas used to have, you know, typed things. And I was seeing, looking at bookings, ki bhai 50,000 letter issue kar rahe hain, 4 customer aa rahe hain. To conversion rate kitna hua? Digital, I mean, 0%. So whenever I see booking figures, I always remember booking only shows an intent. It is not a real customer. And I still remember I was going through, and then I say, hey, there's one customer who got 400 bookings. I found it to Sayyid Modi, who was the badminton player murdered. So obviously he couldn't have bought 4. Even if he had bought, was alive, he would have bought 1. This was a phase which was there. So these bookings was something of phenomena. People used to book for their generations. And this was not seen as a booking for vehicle. This was an investment. Do I invest in a 6-8% government bond, or do I invest in a Bajaj scooter booking? So Bajaj scooter booking was probably a better return. because even if it took 9 years to fructify. So this was that license permit quota raj. The other thing which I learned in 83 to 89 is, you know, if you go through the big automobile groups in India, who had all the best infrastructures, the oldest investment, the best brands, 80% of them have disappeared. They did not go down because the demand of the product was less. They could not go down because their profitability was less in their business they were doing. It was probably something in mismanagement. So 80% of the dealers who were, and they couldn't bear me out, they just don't there. They don't exist. And they didn't quit the business. They just disappeared. So these some very major changes which one saw. Coming on a personal level, I remember in my initial art for my career, one success and one failure story. So what should I recount first, the failure story or the success story? Failure, chaliye ji. So failure story was like this. I was in a motorcycle company, two-wheeler company, and I didn't know how to drive a two-wheeler properly because once I had learned, I had fallen back. So for 1.5 years, I was managing somehow. You know, you had to go to the dealership, give a test drive, this thing. I somehow used to get my way through. But, you know, the fate caught with me in 87 when my company was making a pitch for motorcycles in Punjab because of terrorism in the mid-80s, late 80s. And KPS Ribeiro, who was the police chief at that point of time, and the team had gone. And I was a junior person, like a flunky. Okay, you also come along. Okay, gun. Unfortunately, the main person who was to give a demonstration of the Yamaha 350, which is a 39 BHP motorcycle, he fell ill. He couldn't come. The second person who was to come, he broke his leg. So our head of marketing says, Arun, and in front of Mr. Ribeiro, why don't you demonstrate them the power, the pickup, drive it down here, there. Ab Arun Malhotra doesn't know how to drive a Suvega moped even. Eh? How can he demonstrate a Yamaha 350? So I kept my handle, I know how to kickstart it even properly. So obviously he realized he was an intelligent person. The gentleman is no longer here. And he said, what are you doing? Why don't you start the bike? Mr. Ribeiro is waiting. So the all police chief, everybody waiting, governor was Sudhar Shankar, everybody, and here a small flunky just trying to understand where this motorcycle. So I had to blurt out the truth. Ki sir, mujhe to motorcycle chalana aata nahi hai. The blasting he gave me, I still remember it. Unfortunately for me, the TV channels were not there those days. Otherwise, it would have been telecast live, you know, all the channels. Then he came back and issued a circular to HR. How is a person who's 2 years in sales and last year has got a high grade even, doesn't know how to drive a motorcycle? There's something wrong in your policy. So then the circular was issued in the entire company. So when I used to go for canteen, a worker said, aap hi hai wo na, jo nahi chala paaye the. So this is the point was that it's not that I didn't know that I have to drive a motorcycle. Adil is there, so Adil will say, surprise, yeah, Adil can drive, you know, 1000cc bikes or 1500cc bikes. Now I know how to drive two-wheelers, incidentally. So the point was foregoing something. Kar lenge, seek lenge, abhi zarurat nahi, kar lenge. And then after the incident, I learned all the motorcycles. I could drive a Yamaha 350 in 30 days. But the point was, one thing I learned in automobile or any management is if you forego something which is obvious and you postpone it, you delay it, you procrastinate it, it catches up with you. So that was an experience which I still remember and I can't come over it. The bashing, the public humiliation and the humiliation which followed. Now coming to one success story, although a very small success story. Again, it was in the same period. It's the early part of my career. In my territory of, you know, they used to have a territory, I was area sales manager. So my territory was Haryana, Chandigarh and Jammu Kashmir. But my boss, you know, Srinagar was, you could go by flight there to Srinagar. And my boss always went himself, he never let me go. I used to say, sir, meri bhi territory hai, mujhe jana dijiye. He said, nahi, tum karo yaar, tum kar nahi paoge, tum yahan handle karo, tum Narwana jao, Tohana jao, Fatehabad jao, the typical towns in Haryana. So I just, he didn't allow me because the perk was going to Srinagar and fortunately the law and order was somewhat much better that time. And you were allowed to travel by air, which was not entitlement. Now everybody travels by air. But those days, one of the big things why you wanted to become a manager is that you'll be entitled to travel by air. When you became assistant manager, I didn't tell my wife that I've been promoted. From now I can travel by air. That was the way I communicated. So my boss called me. He says, yaar, tum rote rehte ho. You always keep crying that this is your territory, don't let you go. That dealer does nothing, he doesn't listen to anybody at any level, but we can't do without him in Srinagar. Ab theek hai yaar, tum bhi bahut kaam kiya, 3 days you enjoy yourself. Go and enjoy in Srinagar. Now, this was a rebuke to me that he's saying he's clearing my tour for 3 days for me to enjoy in Shrekar because he doesn't expect I will do anything. I sat down, I said, I was talking to some people, I said, what is the biggest problem in Srinagar? He says the spare parts don't reach there. Because if he orders spare parts, VOR spare parts, they take about 30, 35 days to reach because they go to Jammu and Jammu is unloaded and then goes to Srinagar. So I said, how many orders of his parts are pending? So he said, sir, boy pending hai, but we are about to send because truck is not available. I said, I want to carry the parts tomorrow. He said, are you mad? I said, yes, I want to carry the parts tomorrow. So he said, aap spare parts store chale jao, which was 6 kilometers away. I told them, they said, are you foolish? You want to carry parts? So he says, jitne parts hai, unka weight 34 kg aayega. I said, I'll carry it. So I didn't realize that time. I said, I'll carry it. But those three big boxes were there. Now, how to take it home? Then from home, how to take it to the airport? And I was flying for the first time in my life, incidentally. Yeah? And flying to Srinagar. So kisi tarah ek tempo liya. घर पहुंचाया अब घर पे फर्स्ट फ्लोर पे था वो फर्स्ट फ्लोर चढ़ा नहीं सकता था नीचे रखे चौकीदार को पैसे दिए नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग अगेन वो टेम्पो बुलाया बिकॉज टैक्सी में तो जाने ही थे 3 packs आई कॉल्ड फॉर इट एयरपोर्ट पहुंचा तो एयरपोर्ट ने बोला ओवरवेट है चलो विल पे आई रियलाइज समबडी टोल्ड मी बट ओवरवेट वाज नॉट एन इश्यू दे सेड ये क्या जा रहा है विल नॉट अलाउ इट सो आफ्टर ग्रेट डील ऑफ परसुएशन दे कन्विंस्ड आई पेड दैट 31 kg बिकॉज द अदर बैगेज आई वाज कैरिंग हैंड बैग सो आई पेड अबाउट 11 kg ओवरवेट बट दैट वाज द इजीएस्ट पार्ट The moment I landed in Srinagar, I had those, you know, उसमें लंबे बाल थे अमिताभ बच्चन कॉपी करते थे लंबे बाल कानों पे रखते थे और थोड़ी सी दाढ़ी थी पता नहीं क्या हुआ the airport thought that the biggest terrorist has landed here. So they caught me and those all, you know, because they were all pistons, carburetors, you know, silencers, they were all making noise, I mean all metal parts. And they took me to a room and 4 people investigated and I said, no, I work in this company. They didn't agree and it took 2 hours. But somehow they convinced. Then they opened up all those boxes. Talk. I was packed in a proper manner and the boxes all thrown out. Now he said, okay, theek hai, theek hai. Galti ho gayi aapse, ab le jaiye. Ab wo 3 packs ko pack kaise karo? Pistons lying, bearings lying, crankshaft lying. I don't know how I managed it. Kisi ko tip kiya, kisi kuch kiya. It took me 1 hour to pack it in some manner. So when I came out of the airport, the person who was going to receive me, he got to know. So I came out 4 hours after the flight landed in Srinagar. Flight had ended 9:30. I came out at 1:30 or 2. After all this ordeal. So when I went to the dealership, he had come to know this has happened. So you know what the dealer said? Sir, aapne jo mehnat ki hai mere liye, main kabhi nahi soch sakta. Aap jo boliye karna hai, main karta hoon. Maine bola, aapne ye nahi lagaya identity board. Aapke salesman hi. Anything which he said, I said, he said, yes, done. This draft is required. This payment is not made to this supplier. This done. So he was, you know, he was, and I was a junior officer. But he saw the pain and effort I had taken for his customers and carrying that thing. And when I came back, he wrote a letter to Mr. Nanda even and praising me. So that somehow made up for that other incident of Ribeiro. But point is, if you work from the heart, and he was the most cynical dealer one can think of. But he was cynical because the company didn't care for him. They didn't realize his challenges, didn't realize his thing. So what I'm just saying, and these experiences I've shared with you, You can be the worst in a circumstance, and the same person can be best beyond the call of duty. Because I went beyond the call of duty. I didn't have to carry parts. It was not within my domain. I was a salesperson. But no, that was his biggest pain point. So that's one thing which I learned across the industry. The other thing, the industry took a major phase. You know, if you look at it, 83, 87, 90. 92 was a very changing phase in the auto industry. The government, in 93 or 92, they release their automobile policy. Okay, before I come to the policy, I'll attack another thing. In 88, somehow the 4 Japanese manufacturers convinced the government of India, jaise kehte na, aajkal lambai aur chadai dekhti hai, matlab vehicles mein. Kitna foot lamba hai aur kitna mota hai, CC capacity and length. They introduced a rule in 87, vehicles will have excise on the base of CC. Unfortunately, Rajdoot had 170cc, ESD had 250cc, and Enfield at 350cc. And so what happened, the rural bikes, the bikes which are older Indian manufacturer, 100% indigenized, were charged a higher excise as compared to bikes which were imported, had import content from a foreign manufacturer. And that also sealed the fate of this three. So when the people are talking of GST, the sarkar aise karti rehti hai, jyada sochne ki baat nahi hai. Us samay bhi kiya tha, karti hai, karti rahi hai, karti rahegi. So you have to be ready in some manner. So that was a phase, this was happened in 86. How it was taken? No idea. They had all the figures. just took it on CC. And you'll be surprised, at that time, the price of the 100cc bikes was more than the 175cc Rajdoot. Because we were at the receiving end, I was in Escort. So anyway, the brands were struggling. And this Adelt, no, because the 100cc one, 200cc other, 350cc other. So as you went up to CC, so government has this habit of doing it. They again did it, I think, 97 when they introduced the 4-meter length, which was there. But coming to a bigger point, in 93, the government set out a very automobile policy. I don't know, at that time, you know, if you have to increase production, any automobile company, they had to take permission from the government. If you have to introduce a new model, you have to take permission. If you have to introduce a new CC capacity, you have to take permission. So there was a policy which came in 93 called broad banding, which took three, four major decisions. One, it allowed a 51% equity of the foreign players in the management. Second, it reduced the excise duty, which used to be 70-80%. I'm not talking of GST, to 40%. I'm talking of cars at this point of time. And third, it had this phase management program, which is called broad banding, that if you've got a license for manufacturing vehicles, you can manufacture any CC capacity, any vehicle. So you didn't have to go to government. As long as you have a license, it was part of it. Because of this, you saw the influx of a lot of brands in 97, 98, from phase of 96 to 99. So you had Ford, you had General Motors, you had Hyundai, you had Daewoo Motors, you had even Fiat Peugeot at that time. So the next phase of, you can say, the brands which came in the car market followed because of this policy. Fortunately, motorcycle was not part of it, so the motorcycle manufacturers could come much before. So this was the changing phase as what has happened. Now, you know, one of the things I was talking of, dealers collapsing, some dealers doing well and collapsing. You know, I have tried to do, I'm doing a certain case study, and I know some of these dealerships also. How do you realize, what was the common link of dealers who collapsed? Ek to unka principle tha, no finance management. There's an old Hindi movie song, Aamdani Athani Kharcha Rupaya. Suna aapne gana hai? Suna hai nahi suna hai? Suna hai. Okay. So they had nothing. They used to get a lot of customer advances. They believed it is their money. It was never their money. It was only 3% was their money. 97 was sort of customer. So when that wheel used to stop, suppose the customer, the vehicle came from booking to free sale, the whole system collapsed. वो पैसा खर्च रहे हैं, इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं कोई प्रॉपर्टी में, कोई शादियों में, कोई डोनेशंस में, कोई आशी में, व्हाटएवर इट मे बी डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर टेस्ट एंड स्टाइल्स. सो दैट डिसेबल्ड. द अदर थिंग व्हिच वाज देयर, कस्टमर्स का कुछ नहीं सोचते थे. आई स्टिल रिमेंबर, आई डोंट वांट टू मेंशन अ डीलर, आई वाज अ डीलरशिप, सो दिस वाज इन द 80s. सो कस्टमर आया तो ही सेड, सर ये कार में आवाज आ रही है. ही सेज, तेरे बाप ने भी कार चलाई है क्या? पता क्या है, तू टू व्हीलर खरीद ले जाके, कार वार छोड़ तेरे बस की बात नहीं है. दिस वॉज द एपथी ऑफ सर्टन डीलर्स. थर्ड थिंग विच वॉज देयर, नॉट बॉर्डर्ड ऑन डीलरशिप्स, आई मीन नॉट बॉर्डर्ड ऑन द एम्प्लॉइज इवन. दे हैड सम लॉयल एम्प्लॉइज हुम दे थॉट वर वेरी लॉयल. दे वर सो लॉयल दैट दे वर मेकिंग मनी डे राइट लेफ्ट एंड सेंटर. द होल वर्ल्ड न्यू इट एक्सेप्ट द ओनर्स हु मेक ए मल्टी बिलियनेयर्स. दिस वॉज अ कॉमन लिंक बिटवीन दीज थ्री. एंड दे कलैप्स्ड विद द बेस्ट ऑफ ब्रांड्स in the best of places. There's no reason. Investments all old. Selling products which are no waiting. You getting customer advances. Workshop mein jo earning hogi, wo alag hogi. But this was a common link for people who collapsed and people who prospered. You know, two things I found very, very important, which is, and it runs across over the years. Whoever has followed good HR practices in their dealership, and whoever has got a good financial management, and whoever has focused on customers, they have always done well. Short term, they do badly. Isne discount de diya, usne wo kar diya. But medium term to long term, they do all well. It's like technique. If your technique is correct, Sachin may get out once or twice, Kohli. But overall, the law of averages, they do 50-60. So I'm telling you three common links between, and this is across, it's still valid today. Their theorem is like Pythagoras' theorem. वही है, क्वाड इरान डेमोन्स्ट्रेटम लगा दो. दैट प्रिंसिपल इज स्टिल वेरी वेरी वैलिड. इट इज ओल्ड एज हिल्स. दैट डजंट चेंज. द अदर बिग चेंज इट हैपेंड इन इंडस्ट्री वाज फाइनेंसिंग. पहली बात तो उस जमाने में सोचा जाता था, अगर आपने गाड़ी फाइनेंस करनी है तो कोई चीज, अगर आप लोन लो तो क्या आपका दिवाली निकल गया? दिस वॉज द थिंग, बिकॉज टेकिंग लोन वॉज अ सीन ऑफ सिन. दोज डेज वॉज द एज ऑफ फ्रूगलिटी, व्हिच यू सेड, इफ यू टुक अ लोन वापस कैसे करोगे?
kya baat hai, apne kharche bhi kyun nahi karte? And then if you decided to take a loan, to get a loan in the late 80s, 85, 87 or 89 was a project. You had to file, it was like getting an industrial license in the license quota raj. Documents, interviews, sometimes payment here and there. And 50 days later, or if you are lucky enough, you'll get a loan for buying a vehicle. And uska bhi rate of interest, against the rate of interest of 99.5 would be 14% to 15%. This is one where is a major transformation. And you know, who started this transformation? Can anybody guess who started this transformation on financing of vehicles? Citibank, absolutely right. Citibank came out in the late 80s with a SELP scheme. Jisme tha ki they identified a lot of public sectors across various sectors, and he said, this is the form. They made the form simple. Purana form hota 18 page ka hota tha. Pata nahi kitna bharna padta tha. Aapko apna naam bhi 11 baar bharna padta tha us form mein. Pata nahi kya karte the, ek baar bhar diya to 11 baar kya bharenge, but that was a part of it. They had a 2-page form, and I still remember they called all the two-wheeler manufacturers that time, but they needed financing the most, and said, this is the form, this is the scheme, these are the companies cleared, this is the SELP process, these are our CAs who are post, go ahead and you can finance, and you get undertaking from them. And 356 rupees was the kisht mujhe abhi tak yaad hai for 10,000 rupees, because motorcycles or two-wheelers used to be 18,000 rupees. And I still remember when this scheme came, I had a boss who was a Hitler at that time. You know, nowadays we talk of employee engagement, you know, you have to keep employees happy. So I was resting in my office, sales were not happening, and you know, the monsoon sales used to go down in UP. Anybody from UP here? So UP mein dekha hoga na, June, July ke baad, Eastern UP mein sale gir jati hai, barsaat aati hai, jaisa aajkal chal raha hai. Toh hum baithe hue the, hamari territory UP thi. He says, Arun Malhotra, the SELP scheme has come. Ye forms hain. Tum tour pe jaiye, jitna advance lena hai. Jis din 500 case poore ho jaye, us din wapis aa jana. Mere ko to 50 case nahi dikh rahe the. Ye 9 Northern Coalfields ki unit hai. Northern Coalfield was in this belt of Mirzapur. These are the 3 NTPCs. These are the 3 ITIs. Those of you in Rai Bareilly. Venkesh, you're there? You can empathize with those, na? ITI Naini, ITI Gonda. Hai? Aur mere ko la aap jaiye. You know, will you believe it? I had to talk to union leaders. I had to talk to administrative managers. I had to talk to employees. I had to talk to the Citibank CPAs. After 39 days, I completed the 500 cases. But I did complete it. And I was newly married that time, just a year back. So when I came back, my wife said, tum gore hote the, shaadi ki thi, tum to kale ho gaye ho. So I was something like kala patthar, you know, Amitabh Bachchan in the coal mines. 9 coal mines, ek ek coal mine mein ghusa hu main. Now the point which was that, we were thrown through the wolves. But you know, that experience which was there, I mean, I really, usko pata nahi kitna abuse kiya hoga boss ko, ye aadmi hai ki, he's worse than Hitler even. I mean, koi hisab kitab hai yaar ki go. Maine kaha sir ho gaya, advance chahiye, aa jayega money order se, dealer se le lo, hum usko de denge. I couldn't come back. Jis din 500 ho jaye us din wapas aa jana. 500 to looked impossible to me, but it somehow happened because I had to go back home. That was the only reason I did that 500. So you know what, sometimes you know that hardcore field exposure which sometimes we believe, you know, whether for the second generation of dealers, whether we for our employees, sometimes you are thrown to the wolves and you come out much chastened, much intelligent. I have another example, not from the other industry, and this is about a gentleman called Mr. Vishwanathan. And he was a Bosch chairman for about 7 years, and we were coming back from a great escape. I was in Mahindra that time, and unfortunately vehicles got mixed up, and we were traveling in a non-AC Bolero in 43 degrees centigrade, along with the Bosch chairman who used to BMW 5 series. You know what he said? He said, when I took up my training in the Sun Levers, he was a brilliant record he had, my boss said, where do you want to do your rural stint for 6 months? So they said, you want to, he was Tamil Nadu, so people said, Dindigal chahiye, ki aapko Namakkal chahiye. He said, no, I want to do in a territory which I never heard the name of the place, the language I don't know, the place I never been. So his boss said, are you serious? He says, yes. He gave him ETA. ETA UP, mein pata hai aapko Western UP mein kaun hai dealers ko hai yahan par? So, abhi bhi aap ETA jaiye, to kuch zyada badla nahi hai. He said in the 70s, he said, I went there, I didn't know the language. Wo jo aajkal movie chal rahi hai, Akshay Kumar ki, Prem Katha, wo to wahan par hota hi tha, 360 degrees. And so he said, it was living hell for me. People with abuses, people coming with guns. And I am from a Brahmin strong family in Tamil Nadu. But he took, I didn't know word. He said, I learned Hindi well since 1 year. He says, if I became the head of marketing of Levers and I became the chairman of Bosch, it is because of my 6 months stint in ETA. But the only difference between him and me was I was thrown. He took it willingly. So that's where great people and ordinary people are differentiated. So one, I've talked of financing. The other part is on, when you look at dealerships and the relationships. You know, nowadays there's a big stories, you know, that you have to professionalize their KPIs, their parameters, and you learn from it. I remember, you know, in the old days, you know, you have to learn the language even. I remember when I used to go to Eastern UP in my territory and some part of Bihar, they have a very quaint form of English and Hindi combination. कोई UP से तो नहीं Eastern UP से बहुत लोग हैं तो थोड़ा ध्यान से बोलना पड़ता है. So वहाँ जाइए, वहाँ बोलेंगे आप पहुँचे बहुत देर के बाद, सर फ्रेश हो जाइए. अब समझ नहीं आता फ्रेश हो जाइए क्या बोल रहा है, that meant that you come after a long time है, थोड़ा हाथ मुंह धो लीजिए. या सेकेंड थिंग, यू गो टू कस्टमर, ये थ्रोटलवा से आवाज आवत है बहुत. आई नो विच पार्ट इज थ्रोटलवा, देन आई अंडरस्टूड इट्स अ थ्रोटल. और इफ यू टेल अ डीलर इफ यू डोंट डू दिस टारगेट वी विल अपॉइंट अ पैरेलल डीलर. सर आप बहुत फीलिंग वाला बात कर दिए, बहुत फीलिंग वाला बात कर दिए. अब यू नो सो देयर आर यूनिक कॉम्बिनेशन, सो यू लर्न दीज लैंग्वेजेस, वन डजंट लर्न बट यू नो वन रियलाइज बिकॉज दैट कॉम्बिनेशन फीलिंग वाला. आप हम तो हमेशा टेंशन में रहते हैं, आप और टेंशन मत दीजिए. So, you know, these were the typical things which you learned. Haryana had a different thing, UP had a different thing, South had a different thing. But I think one thing which is important is, in all the pursuit of, you know, things of parameters which have there, relationships is very core to our Indian society. We may professionalize. I know we have to have performance parameters. If you look at dealers, you know, like the balance scorecards, what is your CSI score, what is your SSI score, what is your score on these products, what is your market share, what is the market share in this segment. So there are 20 exam questions, you know, a lot of dealers say, ki kitna questions hai ye par. But, you know, all this element, there is a thing called relationship. And I remember one story of relationship which I can never forget in my life. And this refers not to a company I worked, this refers to Hero Honda. We had a dealer in Srinagar who had run away because of terrorism problems. So I was given the job that the dealer development people from Bajaj Bombay were not going for deal appointment because they thought that the moment you enter J&K, there are bullets flying here and there, which was not the case. So I took up the challenge. I said, I'll go and appoint a dealer, but you give me power to appoint a dealer because otherwise they'll call them for interviews, this thing. I said, it will not happen. If you give me power, I'll appoint somebody. So I identified a Hero Honda dealer there. At that time, because of certain terrorism, motorcycles were banned. And I'm talking of this phase in 93, 94. So I told him, I sat down with him. I looked at other parties which are not good. And I explained to him, dekhiye, motorcycle to ban hai. Hero Honda scooter banane wali nahi hai, hamare paas itne scooter hai Bajaj Auto mein, plus hum three wheeler banate hain. So I showed him all calculation apne tarike se, kitni profitability banegi, aap yahan convert kar lo, aada showroom de do, something, you know, because he was supposed to have a good reputation. He heard me, he said, sir, aapko calculation karni nahi aati, jo aap profit bata rahe ho usse teen guna profit hai, because three wheeler pe 15 rupaye premium chal raha hai yahan par, hain? So aap jo profit bata rahe ho usse teen guna profit hai, par main phir bhi aapki dealership nahi lunga. I said, why? He recounted a story to me. And it, to me, it was the most defining story. He says, sir, 25 saal pehle main cycle ka dealer hota tha. And we, to save money, we used to, cycles used to come, insurance karani padti thi, but we decided, ki paisa bachao, 3 rupaye insurance per gaadi bachta tha, toh humne insurance karai nahi. Aur kehta, humara truck aaya, kahin border mein kahin aag lag gayi, pura truck jal gaya, 150 cycle raakh ho gayi. And he says, mera toh khatam. Forget, mereko bank ke paise, main toh bilkul diwala ho gaya. तो मैंने बोला, लोगों ने बोला भी जाके बात तो करिए कंपनी से, लुधियाना जे ब्रिजमोहन जी से. इसे क्या बात करूं मैं उनसे, वो एडवांस में होते थे. तो कहते मैं ब्रिजमोहन जी के पास गया तो मैंने बताया, जी ऐसा हुआ मेरा ट्रक जल गया ये वो, उसने फिर मैं न्यूज़पेपर भी ले गया दिखाने के लिए. तो ब्रिजमोहन जी ने उसको कहा कि बेटा ठीक है, मैं तुम्हें हर गाड़ी क्रेडिट पर दे देंगे हम आपको साइकिल, और आप चुकाते रहना, पर आपको गिरवी रखना पड़ेगा कुछ. तो कह रहे सर मैं क्या गिरवी रखूँ, जो बताइए कि घर है वो गिरवी रख दूंगा. जैसे नहीं, जो आपका ट्रक जला है ना उसकी जो राख है वो लाके मुझे गिरवी रख दो. ही सेज उस आदमी ने मेरे लिए ये किया है, आज उसको मैं छोड़ दूंगा क्या. द मोमेंट ही सेड आई क्लोज माई बुक एंड वॉकड आउट. नाउ दिस इज द पावर ऑफ रिलेशनशिप. नो वंडर ब्रिजमोहन मुंजाल, हाउ मेनी ऑफ आवर हीरो होंडा डीलर्स देयर, आई मीन हु हैव एक्सपीरियंस प्रोबब्ली मेट ब्रिजमोहन जी. आई हैड एक्सपीरियंस टू मीट हिम ओनली वंस और ट्वाइस. लुक एट दैट थिंग, इमेजिन a person whose truck is burnt, he has no chance, he can disappear, you cannot reach him, he is giving him credit and he is saying, beta, raakh rakh do bas, girvi ke liye. As mortgage. So, this is the power of a relationship. You know, the problem today is, how do you do the right? If you make only a relationship, then business nahi hoga. Ye bhi zaruri nahi hai. Business hi karoge, toh relationship ka hai. How do you draw, how do you make the common link between relationship and business and performance? And it has to be a society, because the manufacturer and the dealer has to work hand in hand. I still know of a case, I can't mention the person. He went to a dealership, he wanted the outstanding cleared. He says, sir, meri beti ko hospital mein, ICU mein, pata nahi kya ho jaye. He says, mari beti ko jo ho, tum meri outstanding clear kar do. Now, you think he did business with him later? He gave up that franchise virtually. So this is the power of a relationship. And in India, we are still an emotional society. If we touch each purpose, I'm not saying if you empathize with others, if you look at others, I'm not saying you have to agree everything the other does. But even if you listen and empathize, I'm sure there could be common meeting grounds. And this is still a business when we talk of auto manufacturers to dealers. Relationship is an important part. Now, coming to government policies, you know, which has a lot has been said. Other blunders. Should I talk another blunder of mine? No names mentioned, because some people might be still in this world, so I don't want to mention names. We were under pressure to appoint a dealer in a big metro city, and we were unable to find. So me and the All India sales head were called by the MD and says, you go and appoint a dealer. I know nothing, you've done nothing. You appoint a dealer in 45 days. So we went to the town, we were not getting a dealer. We got a dealer who had been terminated by another car company. So we knew, we went to him. He said, sir, there was a lot of politics, there's that, we terminated. And we knew it heart to heart, he's been terminated for what reasons? Because of frauds and other things. But he said, yaar, target meet karna hai. Nahi to MD hume shoot kar dega, appoint him. We appointed him. He started, we were very happy, ha ha ha. And 1.5 year later, we had to terminate him. And we're again searching for a dealer on the same roads. So when you take a short-term solution into a thing, and this was with 20 years experience, all the knowledge, all the information available, there was nothing which was not known. But don't look at the tiger, tiger won't look at you. It doesn't happen in real life. Whether you look at it, it's better you look at the tiger, because at least you can face the tiger. If you don't look at the tiger, then probably the tiger will eat you up. And that's what happens. So there is this, whether it's in life or it's in automobile industry, the moment you think short term, whether it's a dealer, whether it's a manufacturer, whether it's a person, whether it's a relationship manager, you start looking at it. The other thing which is important, which is becoming very, very important, is our industry is very manpower intensive industry. Whatever you may say, digital leads, this thing. But manpower is a very important part, because if you look at how many jobs are generated by an average dealer. So just to how many jobs, I mean, each dealership would be having some 200 to 1,000 employees depending on the group. Huh? Rajiv ji, aapke kitne employees hain? Rajiv ji, kitne employees hain aapke group mein? Huh? 2700. Toh bhai, inko toh employment generation ka award milna chahiye government of India se. Matlab, aise bahut saare log hain. So that's why it's not given the status of industry is important. So how do you handle the manpower? How do you make them part of your family? And people who have been able to do it, they do better. Their retentions are better. Their costs are lower. They are at this part of group. So this is something which is a very, very critical in area, which at least I have learned the hard way. So basics, you'll be surprised. Marwadis generally, their dealerships don't collapse. I don't know why. It's nothing because they are good customers. But their financial is very strong. Every day, rokla ginte rehte hain wo. Kitna gaya, kitna discount, kitna return, kitna ye. I'm not saying everybody should become a Marwadi and daily karte rahe. But there are people who do it. And they are successful. Some people don't look at it. So these are things which as I've learned. So these are certain things which remain constant. Now coming to inquiry tracking. Aajkal bada hai. If you go to a dealership, sab humara DMS kaam nahi kar raha, inquiry track nahi ho pa rahi. I tell you the best inquiry tracking in my life I've seen in tractor dealerships in the mid-80s. और आठवीं क्लास पास होते थे एक डायरी लेके जाते थे एक उनका बड़ा सा रजिस्टर होता था तो दे कुड से कस्टमर के जमीन कितनी है ओनर कौन है प्लेज है कि नहीं है फर्दे उसकी करेक्ट है डॉक्यूमेंट फाइनेंस उसको मिलेगा दे शुड ट्रैक बिकॉज देयर वाज नो वॉक इन 11 स्टेजेस इन अ कॉल्ड अ स्पीड रजिस्टर और समथिंग व्हिच यू टू कॉल एंड नाउ डेज वी टॉक ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सो नबील इज सेइंग आई हैव शॉर्ट आउट ऑफ टाइम सो आई एंड माई टॉक हियर ओपन टू एनी क्वेश्चंस थैंक यू वेरी मच
You can raise your hand and ask the questions. And thank you so much for such exhilarating speech, and it has really given a lot of energy to the audience. First question.
Nabil, when you pulled out a plug for me today, I remembered there was a Madhuri Dixit was doing a dance in one Filmfare award. So it was pulled out 11:30, she had to stop the dance. Although I'm not comparing myself with Madhuri Dixit.
Boss Vinkesh this side, after such a big, your 30 years going through, so what's the basic two things to have a very successful dealership in the market?
See, one is delegate well, one is HR. HR in terms of clear roles, delegation, good HR practices, that's a very, very common link. Second thing, chew what you can digest. Agar samne char ice cream padi hai, aur ab bhook nahi hai, to charo ice cream khaoge, to kahin badazmi hogi. A lot of people go beyond that part of it. And third is focus on basics, because results you will get certain basic enablers, and nowadays with DMS, you get a lot of data. You can focus on basics, how your business is doing on whether business parameters or profitability. These are the three things I think which are important.
Thank you, sir. Thanks.
Even though you asked, told me.
See, there are two intelligent people who are too well read. One is Nikunji and one is Adil.
I
have a right to not to answer the questions.
But I must ask you a question. And it's, you mentioned that the Indian way of life is very emotional. And that connect is really something which you transcend. And how much of the humor aspect have you used in your dealings with recalcitrant principals or dealers or suppliers? And also, I believe that you have a very soft corner for music and movies. So how does that thing play out for you? Because I know that I've seen you in action there. So can you share some of those things? And they are very vital soft skills which really come to the fore, you know?
You know, I remember, you know, Maruti had made a very interesting ad, you know, Kancha ad, which was ki going to Leh and then seeing ki service station hai, Rani ki jagah milegi, khane ki jagah milegi, nahi, par Maruti service station milega. Unfortunately, when the ad came out after 2 weeks, the Ladakhi Association raised a question in Parliament and said, this is demeaning, they are calling our small children Kancha, which is like a derogatory servant. So we were told to go and meet the Ladakhi Association. Our MD said, I went there. He says, ye kya matlab hai, aap mazak uda rahe hain Ladakhi ka, Kancha to aajkal dhabe mein jo chai mangate hue hai. I said, nahi sir, aapne Hare Rama Hare Krishna dekhi hai? Kehte nahi. तो मैं उसकी वो रिकॉर्ड ले गया था मेरा गाना सुनिए कांचा रे प्रीत मेरा सांचा आई सेड देवरंद इज रेफरिंग टू मुमताज इज कांचा एंड कांची सो इज इट डेरोगेटरी इट हेल्प्ड आउट दे सेड ओके ओके द होल थिंग डाइड आउट आर एमडी आस्क्ड मी व्हाट हैपेंड आई सेड हो गया सर सॉर्ट आउट
थैंक यू फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ इंफोटेनमेंट सर आई एम राइट हियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू राइट हियर
या
So, I have a question. You represent an industry which is automobile, which is completely standardized. The processes, the practices, they are sort of so well established globally, not only in India, but globally, and in India too, it's going through the same route. But then there has to be a critical, and these players who operate in the automobile industry are not novices. They're purely stalwarts across the globe. Whether the European Union or the Americas or in India or at the APAC region, they're the best in the business. But my question to you, therefore, is everybody knows, a little bit of context, you'll have to bear with me a little bit. So everybody knows that there's a huge impetus on quality of service. Everybody screams from the rooftops and makes a huge yahoo about customer service. But then why there's so much of a non-standardization in the quality of service when it comes to the experience of the customer in this industry?
See. Ultimately, who does the implementation? One is something which you quality from the heart. That's an important point, because if it's not from the heart, it will not follow. Who does the implementation of the quality at the ground level? The dealer and his employees. So if they are not aligned, if they are not motivated, or if they are not directed, then you can have within the same company a phenomenal, in the same city, a best practice. So it's, you know, India is very diverse. One of the problems of India is we are not like Japanese. Japanese, you tell tuck, 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 they'll all go on the straight road. Here they tell, seedha chalo, to char idhar chale jayenge, char udhar aur char udhar. So in the quality of implementation is a big challenge. So I think it's in the implementation challenge, and it's the transmission losses which I square R. The processes are same. So I think it's more of implementation. The plan, do, check, act, which is a normal process, is very strong and important in India. Haan ji, boliye sir.
Quite a few brands when it comes to after sales. Why is it that companies like Toyota are able to manage it, or Maruti is able to manage it more consistently versus some of the other players? And when it comes to say Renault or Nissan or even Datsun,
we are okay in CSI, we're number 3 last year, certainly.
No. Okay, if you're managing 3 different brands, then how do you translate the same experience in terms of the quality aspect? I'm not saying that each brand will be similar, but at least the outright result would be similar. I mean, if the car goes, it comes back.
Very interesting question. This is of culture even of an organization. So when do you inculcate it? Is quality culture originating after you face customer issues, or quality culture originating before the product or before the customer? But let me tell you, in spite of all what you say, there are still variations. In the companies which you might find the worst customer satisfaction scores, there'll be dealers who'll be outstanding. And some of the companies which you think are great may have low scores. But the culture you inculcate, which you can inculcate from day one, see, ultimately has to become a rigor, it has to become a way of life. Unless you have it a way of life, it will not do. If it is just forced as a process, as a system, you'll do it one and forget it then. So I think that's the challenge, and good companies are able to do it. Okay, thank you very much.